to change. Yeah, do it today. I can feel my spirit rising.
Last week on The Biggest Loser. The blue and yellow teams return to the ranch after 30 days at home for one last chance to weigh in and earn a spot back on campus.
Congratulations, yellow team. You are back on campus.
Then, in a punishing challenge, Mike won immunity for the first time.
That's it, Michael! You have won immunity!
I did it, Mom!
And in a surprising weigh-in,
if a team with only one player falls below the yellow line, there will be no need for an elimination. That person will be automatically eliminated and leave the Biggest Loser campus immediately.
John fell below the yellow line, forcing him to leave the ranch immediately, leaving the remaining contestants in shock.
He deserves this more than I do. And he is a better man than me.
But the biggest announcement of all happens now.
I know it's been a difficult week for all of you. But believe me, you haven't seen anything yet. Because the games are about to begin.
Great, just what we need. What else can they throw on us this week that hasn't already been done?
Because this week, you are headed to the United States Olympic Training Center in Colorado. For the next week, you will eat, sleep, and train alongside the best of the best. We're talking about the athletes that represent America in the Olympic Games.
Start of week 6, and we are going to Colorado, baby, Olympic Training Center.
It's time for you all to pack your bags, get some rest tonight, and I will see all of you at the home of America's finest athletes. Good night.
Wow. We're here at the Olympic Training Center with Olympic athletes. I mean, that's the opportunity of a lifetime. No one gets to do that. It's awesome.
Oh, it's amazing.
It's surreal. This place is amazing.
USA! USA! USA!
We're seeing where all of these people have done amazing things. And for us to get to be here, it's just the thrill of a lifetime.
Welcome, everyone, to the United States Olympic Training Center in Colorado Springs, Colorado. This week, you will eat and train and live like an Olympian. But while Olympic athletes compete for their country, you'll be playing for something else this week, yourselves. Because this week, you will be competing as individuals.
Individuals for the red team is going to be a little bit different than individuals for the other teams because we're husband and wife. We've made a commitment to be a teammate forever, and so we have to work to help each other no matter what.
Something else you should know is at the end of the week, two players will be eliminated. The person with the lowest percentage of weight loss will fall below a red line, and they will be eliminated automatically. There will be no vote, no deliberation. And then two more will fall below the yellow line, and one of you will be going home.
This red line is so much like the very first challenge because there was no deliberation, no vote. We just went home.
Sunshine, thank you for everything.
Thank you.
For not giving up on that bike.
It brings back a lot of feelings, you know, like I've been there before. I've had to walk out and go home. And I don't ever want to go back there. I will not go back there.
This week, you will learn what it means to be an Olympian. And to help us do that, we are joined by one of America's most inspiring athletes and star of the U.S. Paralympic team. Please welcome Allison Jones.
Thank you.
We are very lucky to have Allison with us today. She's been named to the United States Paralympic team 4 times, competing in 2 different events, skiing and cycling. She's won 2 silver medals and a gold for skiing and another silver for cycling in 2008. And this year she's going to be going for the gold again in Vancouver. Allison, your story is one of the most inspiring stories I've ever heard. Tell me about your journey.
I was born with my disability, so I haven't known any difference. You know, my mom had me doing every sport possible as a kid and stumbled upon skiing. My mom took me, stuck one ski on my foot, carried me up the hill, pointed me down, and let go. And that was it.
Allison Jones, she was born without her leg, and she has 4 medals. And it's just so great to meet someone that has achieved something so great.
And later on in life, I try to find a second sport to complement skiing during the summer since the snow melts. And I happen upon cycling. I've been doing that for the last 8 years, and now I'm getting ready for my 5th Paralympic Games.
Wow.
Wow.
Woo! Amazing.
Being at the United States Olympic Training Center is so cool for the contestants because they get to see people who have dedicated their entire lives to athleticism. And they're all burgeoning athletes, so it's something for them to aspire towards.
Thank you so much for being here with us today. I think we're ready to get started. If you would do us the honor and light the torch.
Will do.
To kick off this week, we get to light the cauldron with the torch.
All right, let's go do it.
I've only seen it on TV, so it's really cool to be a part of that, and it feels so surreal.
As we were walking down with the torch, Allison hands it off and lets each one of us carry the torch. You feel so much pride to get to do that.
I have always enjoyed the Olympics since I was a little kid. I love the Olympics. And then get that opportunity to hold the torch, I felt proud of that moment.
This place is amazing. I look back 7 weeks ago, and I would never have guessed that I would be at the Olympic Training Center in Colorado with all these athletes. It's a blessing.
The torch is just, it's the spirit of why we're here. It's the spirit of the athleticism of everyone around us. We're 15 overweight people that have to change our lives, and we're here with the most elite athletes in our country. And for us to be able to share that moment is just indescribable.
Allison lit that cauldron. And she lit that cauldron for every single person in the United States. Every single one. That sparked the torch in my heart. Let the games begin. We're ready.
Ready to see this room.
You know, being here at the Olympic Training Center is literally a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Yay! What is this?
Hey, did you get a big autographed flag?
Yeah!
And it's crazy that being fat actually got me to the Olympics, you know?
Welcome to the Colorado Springs Olympic Training Center.
This flag has been signed by all of our resident athletes.
Who are Olympians, Paralympians, and hopefuls.
Team USA is honored to be part of your journey.
We wish you continued success in meeting your goals and achieving your dreams.
Sincerely, resident athletes and staff.
Wow, baby, ain't this nice?
You are in this environment where the enthusiasm to do better, it just resonates from all around you. I mean, just being here, it just resonates.
We'll never pass this way again.
I know.
We will never pass this way again. Yeah. I mean, it just won't happen. I mean, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for both of us.
I'm so excited, Dad.
Wow, baby.
I can't wait to see what this week is going to bring us.
Only good.
Welcome to the USOC.
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
The contestants are going to be eating at the United States Olympic Training Center, so they need to be eating the foods that the Olympians eat, making sure you're getting proper nutrition, not just calories in, calories out. And I thought it would be nice for our nutritionist to reiterate that.
One of the most important things to kind of keep in mind when you're making your choices, and we set this up for all of our athletes, is right here. We have all the nutrition information provided.
You guys are making a huge lifestyle change. So, you know, you have to be monitoring and make sure that your insides are being taken care of.
How many calories are these athletes eating a day?
Depends on the sport. We kind of have a range from, I'd say, 1,600 up to over 8,000.
A day?
The reality of an Olympic athlete is they work out, you know, 6 hours a day. We're working out 6 hours a day. They have to watch what they eat to fuel their body to be able to get through those workouts. We have to watch what we eat to get through the workouts, but also to lose weight.
One of the biggest questions we get asked is, what do athletes eat? There's such a variation, such a variety in what athletes eat. It all depends on the different sports. So this is one of our short track speed skaters here. This was his lunch that he had today. Their training is very, very intense throughout the day, and it's a carbohydrate dominant sport. So he's looking to get the proper fuel in from carbohydrate, protein from the meatballs, the chocolate milk, chicken for recovery, and vegetables as well. Weightlifter. She's looking at getting the carbohydrates in to support her practice. Plenty of fruits and vegetables. Again, carbohydrate from the fruit as well as the pasta. She needs the protein for recovery, that hard, healthy fat from the avocado and guacamole, plenty of fluid. She's got to maintain that lean mass, but also worry about maintaining staying in her weight class.
Everything is healthy. Everything is for a purpose, and it's for fuel. The food here is fuel to keep these athletes going to their fullest potential.
Miles is one of our judo athletes here. He's sitting light, so he actually is trying to gain weight.
Yep.
Notice the composition of this. He wants to make sure he's putting on the right weight. So he's got that balance of carbohydrates, fruits and vegetables, and lean protein. If you have any questions while you're here, while you're training and going through meals, don't hesitate to ask us any questions and let us know what we can do to help.
Thank you.
What are you looking at?
It just looks really good. I used to eat this.
I have a total sweet tooth, and I noticed some chocolate cake and some goodies in this case by the door, and that's stuff that I normally would eat. I love dessert.
I mean, it looks really good, but this is what I have to say. I would much rather you have something like extra sugar-free gum that's gonna be a 5-calorie treat as opposed to snacking on something like this. It's gonna be about 400 calories. It can actually reduce the sweet snack cravings of this.
I think the 5-calorie sugar-free gum is a great option for me to help curb that craving.
Ooh, okay. Polar ice is my favorite.
Well, let's go back.
You good? Just thinking about John, that's all.
I'm sorry to tell you that you are not the biggest loser. It is time for you to go.
You know, I can't get John off my mind. I can't get how he left. You know, and it's still bothering me.
He's a family man. He's got a kid. He's got a wife. He's got so many more things that are more important than me. I have nothing. I mean, I guess it goes all back to how I value myself.
You really just hit it on the head when you said it. It truly is how you value yourself.
I just think he needs it more than I do.
Why am I worthy of this? I haven't done anything in my life. Like, this truly is one of the greatest blessings I've ever had. And so I'm struggling on finding myself worthy of this.
In this last couple days, I keep fighting it. I keep fighting the growth that I need to go through, you know, because it's too hard. And when it gets too hard, I'm used to running. And I want to run so bad. You know? Because I've never done anything for myself. So it's just letting the walls down, letting it all down, and just letting it happen, letting it work, letting myself grow, you know, instead of running away through it, run into it, and let it beat me down so I can come out a better man.
We can handle the hard work. We can handle all of that. But this is why we're here.
All right, guys, come on in. We have some Olympians for you to meet.
Yo.
Alpine skier Julia Mancuso.
Hi.
And freestyle skier Speedy Peterson.
How's it going, guys?
Good.
You see this guy on skis. I am not kidding you. This guy is like getting shot out of a cannon, flipping around. Tell him.
I have a trick that I do. It's called the hurricane. It's 3 flips with 5 twists. We go about 55 feet up into the air. It takes about 3.2 seconds.
Wow. I thought it would be neat for the contestants to meet people like Speedy and Julia who had a dream and pursued it. That's what I think is really special about the Olympics, is that it's about making your dreams come true.
I've just been skiing my whole life. I grew up in Squaw Valley, California, and I guess from there I just had a dream, and I love to be fit, and I'm glad that I can be here and show you some of the stuff that I do.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Julia's a gold medalist.
Wow.
Yeah, you're not just meeting them. You're going to be working out with them.
Get ready to sweat.
Guys, come with us. Let's go.
I'm going to have a circuit set up for them. 3, 2, 1, go. We're just going to go from station to station. Come on. Go. Get him going. No stops in between. How bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? All right, switch. 10 more seconds. Keep it up. You can do anything for 10 seconds. We're going to get these guys in here. They're not gonna stop until we're done.
Olympic workout.
Come on, get those push-ups going, guys.
Do not drop me.
I'm done. I'm done.
Whoa.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's no joke. There's a reason she won a gold medal, obviously. That must be it.
There are not even words to describe how unbelievable it is for an average Joe to work out with an Olympic athlete. I mean, it's ridiculous, insane.
Catch him. Right, that was excellent.
Nice.
I'm sorry. You knock the ladder, you do push-ups. Make them do it.
So
you do not have to be nice. If they mess up, you feel free to punish them.
You had to walk on both two balls and hula hoop on a ball and balance and run through ladder steps. And it was really cool to train with her, and it was very exciting.
Oh, who pushed the ladder? 5 push-ups after your jump.
Being here in Colorado Springs, you know, we're over 6,000 feet, and the altitude is getting to me.
Keep it going. You don't see her resting. Let's go.
Do it again. Let's go. Harder. Come on, Coley. You belong in this house. Let's go. There's madness going on, right? We've got Speedy over here training these guys. I'm over here training the other guys. Come on, Darius. Everything you got. Think about that red line. 2 people are going home this week. We have a yellow line, and we've got that damn red line. And when you fall below the red line, you're walking out the door. You're not going home this week, Darius. And at one point, Speedy looked at me and was like,
Bob, you think these guys need a break?
No, these guys do not need a break. I'm like, Speedy, these guys don't get a break. They can rest after the Olympics.
There you go. Keep going.
Circuit training is nonstop.
Keep your heart rate up.
Switch.
Relentless. couldn't catch my breath. Moving, 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 moving.
Get him up. All the way.
Intense.
4, 3.
This is horrible.
True. Hard.
One more.
Olympic workout.
Good. All right, you guys. You did a great job up here.
You guys make me feel like a wuss.
No way.
I don't work out that hard. You guys are an inspiration to me and everyone at home. You better be an inspiration to yourselves.
All right, guys. The one thing that you need to have in your mind right now is the red line. There's no time to rest here in Colorado. Right, Coley?
Yes, sir.
That's right. All right, let's go. Good job.
Coley's been struggling, and I can see it in his eyes. Coley doesn't feel like he deserves to be here. He feels like John deserves to be here more than Coley.
As soon as John left, it's like, I don't know, I felt that he needed to be here more than I do, and I felt totally unworthy of it. And ever since then, I've just been on the low, like, can't find the energy to even want to be here every moment of the day.
Don't get so wrapped up in John deserves to be here more than Coley, because John's not here now. And when you start seeing yourself through my eyes, you're gonna be invincible, because I think you're fantastic.
Coley has an opportunity for a big turning point right now. And it makes me nervous, because he could either go so far in one direction of I am out of here, or all right, I'm gonna trust this process. And who knows where he's gonna go right now.
Let's focus on you and all the people that need your help when you go home. That's what you need to think about, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hey, America. Olympic aerialist Jeret Speedy Peterson here. And I want to give you a tip for this next commercial break. What we're going to work on is lunges. And we're going to bend down to a 90 degree and then come back up. We're going to do that with our opposite leg. We're going to do that for this entire commercial break. Good luck with it, and be sure to cheer me on this year in Vancouver.
Coming to the Olympic Center, I knew that it wasn't going to be a vacation. It's going to be hard. It's going to be challenges and pushing ourselves like Olympians do.
Becoming an Olympic champion boils down to one thing. When their big day comes, they simply have to push harder than everyone else. And to win today's pop challenge, that's exactly what you're going to have to do. To show you how today's pop challenge is going to work, please meet Olympic hopeful J.R. Celski. J.R., thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, ma'am.
I think everyone here would really be interested in hearing your story. You're going to be competing in 3 different events in the Olympics this year, but tell us how you got there.
I'm a short track speed skater. I started speed skating when I was 3 on inline with the wheels. I'm 19 now, and I've been doing it for 16 years. Well, 2 months ago, if you can believe it, I was in a hospital bed, not able to move.
Wow.
I was at Olympic trials, and the last day I wound up putting my blade into my leg, and I have a scar right here.
Oh,
to prove it.
Oh my God.
The worst thing I've ever experienced, but I bounced back.
Hey. Wow, that's wonderful.
I guess it's just proven to me that no matter what situation you're in, you gotta get back up, and that's all you guys have to do. Is to be dedicated to what you do and really, really go for it.
Thank you.
The positive message of his story was just to keep on going. And even if you get injured or if you fall behind or if you get frustrated and you want to give up, you know, look forward and move ahead.
Okay, guys, this is how today's pop challenge is going to work. Each of you has a slide board. All you have to do is slide back and forth. Each time you touch a side, you get 1 point. To finish, you need 500 points. Because it's Olympic week, there isn't just one prize. There are 3. I can't tell you what those prizes are.
Oh.
But I can tell you that they're worth their weight in gold and silver and bronze. The first three finishers in today's pop challenge will get advantages in this week's main challenge.
Oh, awesome.
So pay attention to JR. JR, are you ready to demonstrate the slide board for us?
Yes. So have you guys ever seen this before?
No.
Okay, so it's...
Whoa.
I'm just kidding. It's a little slippery, so be careful. It's like stepping on ice. Put as much pressure as you can into this post right here, and you're gonna push to the side.
He made it look so simple. But of course, he's an Olympic athlete. We're not. I have a feeling getting on that board is not gonna be as simple as he makes it look.
Okay, due to medical reasons, Daryl, Miggy, and O'Neill will be sitting out. The rest of you, get on your slide boards. On your mark, get set, go.
Whoa.
All right, there's a learning curve here. Gotta get comfortable. Michael's got his own technique for getting across the slide board. Melissa looks like a natural out there. Not as easy as it looks.
All good. All good.
And Melissa's the first one to 100.
Yes! Melissa's at 100. 400 to go. Let's keep moving.
Second place, we got Sam at 96. Sunshine's at 85. Lance at 83. Darius is at 80. Everyone fighting to be in those top three spots.
Oh, God.
Melissa's at halfway, 250. Right behind her is Sam. 250 for Sam. He's halfway there. Sam at 350. He is right on Melissa's heels. Sam, 2 points away from Melissa. He's catching up to her. Looks like Sam's getting faster as Melissa's slowing down.
I can feel it in me. It's all gas, no brakes. And I'm in the zone, and no one's stopping me.
Let's go, Sam.
Melissa and Sam fighting for that lead.
Let's go, Melissa.
Sam is catching up at that point, and I literally cannot breathe.
Come on, push through the pain, guys.
I'm a competitive person, and I don't want to lose.
Sammy, don't fall, baby!
Win or nothing else. Let's go.
This is it. They're tied. Sam and Melissa tied for first place.
Woo! Come on, Melissa.
And Melissa is down.
Wow.
I can't feel good. That's it. 5 left for Sam to win the gold. 4, woo! 3, 2, 1. Woo! That's it.
Don't stop, Sunshine!
Here we go, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it! That is silver for Melissa! Congratulations! 1 medal left to give out. The bronze finisher. Is it gonna be Sunshine? She's at 450, Lance at 443. The top three finishers get an advantage.
My groin was sore, my feet were sore, my calves were sore, everything. And I'm out of breath, and I have to finish in the top three. I want to be one of the top three finishers.
5 points separates them. 5 points for the bronze medal.
Come on, Lance, focus.
Come on, Sonny. Come on, Sonny.
Now it's a battle for the bronze. It is on, and it is tight.
Pick it up,
Sonny. Don't let it go, Sonny.
Come on, Sonny.
2 separates them.
That's my girl.
Lance struggles.
Push it, Lance. Push it. I finished. I got 3rd place. I saw it and I went for it and I took it. I feel like I'm proving myself in this house. Lance and Darius, they're strong competitors and I really showed them up today.
I'm very proud of Sunshine. This is just a springboard to anything she wanted to do in her life now.
With the silver, it's Melissa.
There you go.
There you go, Sam!
Took the gold, man. Brought it home for the family. fired home for Coley. Boom. And this is quite the victory from where I was at in my life and to where I'm at right now.
This season, The Biggest Loser was honored to train alongside America's finest athletes at the United States Olympic Training Center. And while we get to help our contestants fulfill their dreams, the U.S. Olympic athletes depend on people like you to make their dreams a reality.
Help support our Olympic athletes by donating to the United States Olympic Committee at TeamUSA.org. And be sure to cheer them on as they go for the gold on NBC and NBCOlympics.com.
Garden of the Gods. It's one of the greatest names I've ever heard to call a state park. It really is something that only the gods could make.
Welcome everyone to the Garden of the Gods. This is the location for your Olympic Week challenge in beautiful Colorado Springs, Colorado. I'd like to introduce you to United States Paralympian Kelly Underkofler. We are so lucky to have Kelly here. When she competes in Vancouver, it will be her third Paralympic Games. Kelly, why don't you tell them a little bit about your story?
I was born missing my left arm, so this is, you know, something I've lived with my whole life, and I know you guys can certainly understand living with something for a long time and having it be a challenge that you have to overcome day after day after day.
When you're overweight or obese, our biggest thing is moving. You know, and you see these athletes with these different handicap situations, and I mean, they do extraordinary things.
Olympic athletes aim for the gold. Well, for today's challenge, all of you will be aiming for something else, each other. Today's challenge is based on one of the most difficult events at the Winter Olympics, the biathlon. As you obviously know, the biathlon is a combination of cross-country skiing and shooting.
I've got this in the bag. That's all I've done all most of my life is hunt. I'm not an expert shot, but it puts food on the table, literally.
Today, because it's The Biggest Loser, we're going to do things a little bit different. There won't be cross-country skiing. Today, you will run around this field. Every trip around, you get the opportunity to take a shot at a target. If you hit the target, it will light up. If your target is hit 5 times, you're out. Last remaining person wins. Kelly's gonna show you how the Biggest Loser biathlon is gonna work. Come on, let's do a demonstration, okay? All right, guys, come on up. All right, Kelly, show us how it's done.
All right. You wanna have your hip kind of sticking out so your elbow can brace up against your hip and your rib cage. You sight through the rifle. The 5 holes at the top are what you're trying to hit. Take your shot, and the light comes on if you have a hit.
The gun we use is a little laser gun, and when you pull the trigger, it just shoots a little laser burst that connects with your target and turns on the big light that says you hit it.
Before we get started, I have some awards to give out. Sunshine, Melissa, and Sam, you came in bronze, silver, and gold at the Pop Challenge this week, which means you get an advantage at today's challenge. Sunshine. Because you came in bronze at the Pop Challenge, you will receive the opportunity to hit one target right now. Melissa, you came in silver, you get to hit 2 targets right now. Sam, for the gold, you get to hit 3 targets right now. So we're gonna start with you, Sunshine.
I'm gonna have to pick Sam. She's a fast runner.
So that's 1 point against Sam. Melissa, you have the opportunity, since you came in silver at the Pop Challenge, to choose 2 people to assign points to, or you can give it to 1 person and give them 2 points.
Sam, I love you, but you're gonna get both of mine.
Come on. For real? Is this happening to me?
Okay, Sam, you have 3 to give out. Who are they going to?
All 3 of them will go back to the same folks that took them at me. So I got 1% and then 2 for Melissa.
So much for an advantage in this game.
Sam, Sunshine, and I came into this challenge with an advantage. And we ended up shooting ourselves in the foot and giving each other the shot, so we ended up with the disadvantage.
Sunshine, you're starting off with 1 point against you. Melissa, that's 2 points against you. And Sam, you have 3 against you. The prize for today's challenge is the best prize you can get in this game. Immunity.
Immunity this week, it doesn't compare to any other week for me. Being in Colorado, away from the ranch, away from our groove, it's kind of like going on vacation. Coming back from that into a weigh-in where there's a red line, that somebody's just going home right off the scale, and two other people fall below the yellow line, this week's immunity is by far the most valuable of them all.
Okay, guys, we're getting started. Woo! On your mark, get set, go! Sam, at Lance's target, Dara's waiting in line behind him.
When I'm standing up for Lance's target, I'm trying to like slow my breathing down, but it's doing me no justice.
Lance has 1 point, thanks to Sam.
Nice work, nice work.
Dara has 1 point, thanks to Lance.
I turned around and looked, and there was 5 or 6 people just stacked up one behind the other right on my target. Literally, looked like everybody was lined up to a kissing booth buying tickets.
This could be it for Lance. O'Neal takes out Lance. Lance is out of his competition. Ashley sizing up at Miggy. So Sherry's got 1 against Coley. Melissa has 4 against her. 3 points against Stephanie. 3 points against Sherry. 3 points against Sunshine.
As I was running around and people started getting targets added up against them, I realized that all I have to do, if someone has 4, is shoot the 5th one and they're gone.
There it is, that's 5, Melissa, you're out.
So that's what happened with Melissa. I came around the circle, Miggy had 4.
Got Miggy!
I shot her 5th one, Miggy's out. Came around the circle, Daris had 4. I shot his 5th one, Daris was out.
Got Daris! Daris is out of this competition, that's 5 points.
And every time it just felt like I'm 1 person closer to immunity. And that was my goal the whole time.
3 points against Stephanie, 3 points against Sherry, 3 points against Sunshine, 4 points against Mike.
I went up to Michael's target and I hear him behind me.
Stephanie, let me get 1 more.
And I looked back at him, made eye contact, turned back and said, nope.
All right, that's it, that's 5 points against Mike. He's out, come on back, Mike. That's it, Dreyer, you are out. Sunshine is out of this competition.
Yeah!
O'Neal happily gets Coley out of this competition.
Between the running, the thin air, my bad knee, the only thing I had to compensate for all that is being able to shoot.
O'Neal on his way to take care of Sam.
Yeah!
Sorry, Sam. It's a game.
You got 1 point left, Stephanie. You better run if you're gonna make a count. Daryl steps up.
You shot me, girl. You got it coming.
This is a pretty exhausting thing for me. After the shot, all it was getting around for another lap as fast as I could.
Cheryl takes Sherry out. Ashley looking to take Cheryl out. That's it, Cheryl. You are out of this competition. 3 people fighting for immunity. O'Neal, Daryl, and Ashley.
I'm thinking, I definitely can see immunity coming to me.
Looks like anyone's game here. Where's O'Neal gonna go?
I'm thinking, these two men both have knee problems. I'm like, I can totally take these people out.
Yeah!
Ashley with 4 hits. Who's Daryl gonna take out, O'Neal or Ashley? Daryl goes right by O'Neal, heading for Ashley. O'Neal and Ashley fighting for immunity. She's got 4 hits against her. That's it, Ashley. You're done. Come on back.
I'm out.
God, I was so close to getting immunity. 3rd place ain't bad for always being last, so it felt really good to be up higher on the board this week.
Push it down, down to the final lap. O'Neal versus Daryl is running to catch up.
Move, Daryl, if you want it. How bad do you want it, Daryl? How bad do you want it, Daryl? How bad do you want it? No pain.
I'm in a lot of pain when I run because my knees are inflamed and they hurt so bad.
Come on, Dad!
This challenge, I never felt my knees.
Come on, Dad!
You know, I've got strength that I haven't had in 20 years. I've got stamina now. I'm ready to go to the next level.
Earlier on The Biggest Loser.
Look at that.
That was
the contestants travel to Colorado to spend a week at the United States Olympic Training Center. Where they got the chance to train with some of America's finest athletes.
I can do anything for 10 seconds.
Olympic workout.
Now, in a challenge to be the last man standing, two fathers battle for immunity, and it comes down to one last shot.
O'Neal versus Daryl is running to catch up. Two dads, two fathers, fighting it out. Who's it going to be, O'Neal or Daryl?
Run it, Dad! Run it, Dad! Run it, Dad!
O'Neal stepping up to Daryl. Daryl stepping up to O'Neal. This is the final shot.
Come
Who's going to get it off?
Get him, Dad. Focus, Dad. Come on, Dad.
O'Neal is going to have to get that shot off. And that's it. Yeah. Daryl. Takes him down! O'Neal with immunity! Congratulations!
I'm just so proud of my dad because he went out there and got immunity all on his own, and he did it. Look at him. He was competing in a challenge and he won. That's like, it's so inspiring for me.
Congratulations, all of you. Enjoy the rest of your trip in Colorado. Next time I see you, we'll be back on campus for the weigh-in. Thank you, Kelly, for doing this. We're happy to see you.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
See ya. I just won immunity. I'm so happy. Wow. Yes.
We just come back from Colorado. We've got to be working out, but we decide we're going to take them off campus.
How's it going?
Good.
How you doing?
All right, how you doing?
When we walked into the 24-Hour Fitness, I wanted to introduce them to someone. Rockne Brubaker, Paris figure skater. He didn't look like a Paris figure skater. He looked like a rugby player. So, Rock, you want to tell them your story?
Yeah. My skating partner, Kiana, and I were the two-time U.S. national champions. Excited to be here, and we're going to get a good workout in today, so.
And we're going to be doing a boot camp class. 24-Hour Fitness is known for their boot camp classes, and you guys know that the cool thing about group instruction is it's social, it's fun.
It's also a great form of motivation, too.
All right.
So let's get it going. Jump up, do the burpee, come down, feet back, push up, come up.
Pop, seven, pop, six, ass down. You know, I'm hoping that they had a lot of fun in Colorado. I hope they had fun with the Olympians. That's awesome. And so now what we're gonna do is get back to work.
Last chance workout, let's go. 10 more. Up, up, nice. You're back at sea level now. This should be easy for you. Nobody knows how to train these contestants like Jillian and I. We got 20 more seconds right here. Keep going. We're with Rockne and he's like, should we, you know, can I do this with them? I'm like, can you do this? Like, I have them doing one-armed handstands on the wall. Dude, beat them up.
Where are we at, Mike?
50.
50? Okay, let's do 105 then. Come on, last chance workout, let's go. Let's get five more, come on. And let's not stop, no break in between, no break in between. Think you got one more in you?
This last chance workout, I'm gonna give it all I have.
Come on, you can do it. There you go.
And then I'm gonna give it all that I don't have.
Lower, 10, go, 9, ass down, 8.
All right, guys, finish that set strong. It's the last chance workout, come on now. There you go.
Last two, and one.
Thanks for having me, guys. My pleasure.
Well, you guys think you're done with your last chance workout, but you know you're not. So let's get back to work.
It was a lot of fun. The boot camp class was great for all of us, but the last chance workout has not even begun yet.
Go, go, go! Dig deep. We've been traveling. It's a less than ideal scenario. I need you to focus right now. I need you to sweat it out.
My legs, my quads were just on fire, but it's the last chance workout. We have a red line and a yellow line this week, and that's what we've got to do. We've got to push as hard as we can because we've got to stay above those lines.
Remember, you've got a red line coming up, a red line, and do you want to be below it? No, then keep going.
Colorado was like a vacation to me, and it was difficult to get our workouts in and always eat the right food at the right time. So this last chance workout is going to be everything. I got to go all in.
Last chance workout, Coley, let's go.
We all are scared. There's two people going home this elimination. You can just feel everyone in there just pushing, like doing three more extra push-ups when they say do 10, you do 13. Like, everyone's just going above and beyond, and we all need it.
5, 4, 3, 2, let's go.
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah.
There we go. Last chance workout. 10, 9.
I have a goal this week that I set up for myself a couple weigh-ins ago, and that was to lose 100 pounds in 6 weeks, which would beat Rudy's record for 100 pounds in 7 weeks.
You did it! You have set a Biggest Loser record. You've lost 101 pounds in 7 weeks.
I have to lose 17 pounds this week to beat that record. So this week's, you know, last chance workout is a big deal to me.
Yes! Come with me. You better be impressive right now, okay? I had a moment with O'Neal, the kind of moment that I live for. Oh, we ain't done yet. I got O'Neal, this poor man with those crippled knees of his, standing on this Bozu ball. You got this. I'm right here. I had him standing there on his own, and then I had him doing these little squats.
Squatting.
Oh, hell no.
He's squatting.
Do that one more time. Abs in strong. Good. Stand up tall. Grab onto me. And come up. His face was like lighting up the whole gym. For me, that's what the Biggest Loser is all about. I mean, it's about giving these guys their lives back. It's about giving these guys ownership of their bodies again. I mean, it's real. I mean, what we do here is real, and it's special. That was your last chance workout. Let's go.
That's good, Dan.
All right, people, you've been watching us for 9 seasons. It's time to get off the couch and get in shape. Visit NBC.com and apply to be a contestant right now. You could be the next Biggest Loser.
At the last weigh-in, I told you that the games were about to begin. Well, this week certainly did not disappoint. For one whole week, you ate, trained, and lived like America's most elite athletes. With one major difference. Olympic athletes focus on the finish line. All of you had two lines to worry about this week. The yellow line and the red line. Tonight you will weigh in as individuals, and it is the player with the lowest percentage of weight loss who will be automatically below the red line and eliminated from this game. There will be no vote, no deliberation. You'll be asked to leave the Biggest Loser campus immediately. And like all weigh-ins, there will be two people who fall below the yellow line. And one of you will be going home.
Everyone is a little somber, knowing that at the end of this night, two people are not going to be in the house. And it's a scary feeling.
O'Neal, you won the challenge this week, which means you have immunity. Let's put you on the scale, see how you did. O'Neal, last week you weighed in at 333 pounds. Your current weight is You lost 8 pounds in a week that you had immunity.
To me, it's really not about immunity. It's for my long-term goal of, you know, getting healthy. So, you know, the trainers, you know, working the hell out of me and seeing that I'm doing everything right, you know, and I just have to keep going.
Good job, O'Neal.
I lost 8 pounds. I mean, not only do I feel amazing for losing the weight, I feel healthier.
O'Neal, you lost 8 pounds, but since you have immunity, we are going to take your name off the scoreboard. O'Neal, you are here for one more week. We're going to be weighing in 14 people tonight. Michael, we're going to start with you.
Walking up to the scale, I want to see how well I did for a week that I wasn't here on the ranch. And I really want to make that record of losing 100 pounds in 6 weeks to beat Rudy. It's going to be a huge boost of motivation for me.
Michael, since you came to campus, you have lost 83 pounds. If you lose 17 tonight, that will be 100 in 6 weeks.
No pressure.
But it will mean that you have set a new Biggest Loser record, the player quickest to lose 100 pounds. Well, let's see what you did this week. Michael, your previous weight was 443 pounds. Your current weight is? 100, but wow, Michael, you lost 11 pounds this week. You are in the double digits again.
I'm doing it. I really am. I'm doing it. And I'm doing it right. It feels good.
All right. Thank you, Michael. Congratulations.
I didn't hit the 100-pound record, but I'm feeling really good because now that I'm back here and I'm back to my routine, I'm definitely going to share that record and then some. Sorry, Rudy.
Congratulations, Michael. You lost 11 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 2.48%.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to weigh in Stephanie.
Walking up to the scale, it's overwhelming because it's been a crazy week. You know, we've been traveling. We weren't able to use our own gym, and I'm all about routine and consistency, so it puts me on edge.
Stephanie, your current weight is? 4 pounds in a week where you were traveling, not sure. How do you feel about that?
I feel good. 4 pounds is 4 pounds, and we have a lot of other people to weigh in, so I'll wait and see, and as we get closer, I might get more anxious, but I'm proud of myself.
Thanks, Stephanie.
I just hope it's enough to keep me here because 4 pounds is usually on the lower end, so I'm going to be looking forward to seeing what all the other people pull this week.
Stephanie, you lost 4 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 1.78%. Stephanie, we have 12 people left to weigh in. Next, we're going to weigh in Sunshine.
Even though I had immunity, I'm still petrified. You know, I'm thinking about my daughter. I want her to stay here with me and get as much out of this as she can. And I would love to give her my immunity. I would give her my immunity without even no hesitation or reservations about it.
Sunshine, your previous weight was 245 pounds. Your current weight is? 7. You seemed pretty nervous up here before you saw that number.
Yes, I was. I mean, coming up here, I'm always going to be nervous, and especially I wasn't weighing with my dad. I'm here by myself, so it's kind of different this week, but I'm glad to see I lost 6 pounds.
Okay. Thank you, Sunshine.
Thank you. When I saw a 6 pop up there, I was so relieved. 6 pounds is a really good number, and I'm just hoping it's enough to keep me safe.
Sunshine, you lost 6 pounds this week for total percentage of weight loss of 2.45%. Coley, you're next.
Coley's had a really tough week. After losing John last week, he almost feels like he doesn't deserve to be in this house anymore. He needs a good number. We're trying to create a new history for this man. and he has got to stay here for as long as possible.
Cole, your previous weight was 335 pounds. In order to guarantee your safety tonight and be above both lines, you need to have lost more than 8 pounds. Cole, your current weight is...
8 pounds.
Oh, yeah.
You bounded up those stairs tonight. Did you know you were gonna have a good number?
It felt good. As soon as I got home, I worked out as hard as I could. Real big thanks to Bob. Never really had a big brother, but prefer to have one be Bob. He gave me some good advice this week.
Was there something specific you and Coley talked about this week, Bob?
We wanted to make sure that Coley knew where his place was in this house and how much he deserved to be here. And it was up to me to really show him that. Coley's a really, really good man.
Thanks, Coley.
I have grown a lot in this week, more than I have in the last couple years of my life. The greatest motivation that I've discovered is me. Doing this for me, doing this for my future family, doing this so that I can progress in life.
All right, Coley, you lost 9 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 2.69%. Puts you in first place for right now with three people below you. Coley, you are definitely safe from elimination. Congratulations. All right, guys, we have 10 people left to weigh in. Next, Drea.
Walking up on the scale, I will not be happy to see another 5 pounds. It's been 2 weeks. I'm ready for a bigger number. And I know I worked really hard this week.
Drea, in order to guarantee your safety, be above both lines tonight, you need to have lost more than 6 pounds. Your current weight is...
2 week 5 pound streak, and I'm moving on up to bigger and better things.
Thank you. Another proud papa moment. Drea, you lost 7 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 2.67%. That's three people below you, so you're definitely safe from elimination, Drea. You are here for another week. Daryl, it's your turn.
Going into this weigh-in alone, I hope I have the right stuff. I'm walking up the steps to get on the scale, and I know this week's not been my best week. I had some real good workouts. I just didn't get as many in a day as I typically would here at the ranch.
In order to stay safe from elimination, in order to get above both lines right now, you need to have lost more than 8 pounds. Daryl, your current weight is...
100. It's not where I want to be, that's for sure. You know, I work hard.
Okay.
Five pounds weight loss should be a fantastic thing, but it's not a good week for Biggest Loser.
Daryl, you lost 5 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 1.46%. But we do have lots of people left to weigh in. Sam, you're next. Sam, your previous weight was 310 pounds. In order to guarantee that you are above both lines tonight, you need to have lost more than 7 pounds. Sam, your current weight is?
Proud of that, huh?
My goal was to get under 300. I haven't been there since I was 15 years old. Who at 15 feel good about themselves knowing that they're 300 pounds?
Well, congratulations, Sam. In 6 weeks, you have lost 74 pounds.
You know, it just feels so good. Negative 12? Are you serious? Like, just to get under the 300s was amazing, but to just kill it, it's none of the smiles, man.
Sam, you lost 12 pounds for a total percentage of weight loss of 3.87%. Congratulations, Sam. That's good enough for first place right now, and you are definitely safe from elimination tonight. Next, we are going to weigh in Sherry.
Walking up to the scale alone is scary. I had a 6 last week, and that was a pretty good number. I'm hoping that I can do somewhere close to that this week, but I don't know. It's getting harder. You know, I'm getting smaller, and it's getting harder to pull those numbers, but I really hope I can do it.
Sherry, your previous weight was 180 pounds. In order to guarantee your safety, be above both lines right now. You need to have lost more than 4 pounds. Your current weight is...
5 there. It was a rough week.
Always something to work on, huh?
Yeah, always something to work on.
Well, thank you, Sherry.
Thank you.
Sherry, you lost 3 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 1.67%. Sunshine, with 3 people below you, you are definitely safe from elimination tonight. Stephanie, Sherry, Daryl, you all in danger of falling below the yellow line. Daryl, still in danger of falling below the red line. Next, we're going to weigh in Ashley.
My mom and I worked out a lot together, and we ate very similar. So when I see that she's only lost 3 pounds, I'm thinking to myself, does that mean that I'm not going to have a good number this week, too? Because we did pretty much the same thing.
In order to guarantee your safety, you need to have lost more than 5 pounds. Your current weight is...
6 pounds, and I'm relieved because I'm safe.
Ashley, you lost 6 pounds for a total percentage of weight loss of 1.89%. The 3 people below you, Ashley, you are definitely safe from elimination. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Darius, you're next. Darius. In order to guarantee that you are above both lines, you need to have lost more than 5 pounds. Your current weight is... 9 pounds this week, Darius.
Feels good. It's a lot easier to run these days.
Good job.
My mom and I weighed in front of all the people that we know and love, and we promised them that we were going to make it to the end, and I plan on winning. That's why I came here.
Darius, you should know after 6 weeks, you have the highest percentage of weight loss of anyone on campus. Congratulations. Darius, you lost 9 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 3.18%. Congratulations, Darius. That's good enough for second place.
Next, we're going to weigh in Cheryl. Cheryl, in order to guarantee your safety right now, be above both lines, you need to have lost more than 3 pounds. Your current weight is 3 pounds. Your current weight is. Frustrating.
It is. 3 pounds, that's, you know, I did expect it to be more this week.
I missed it by 1 pound. And I have 3 pounds instead of 4 pounds, which is what I needed to stay above the yellow line.
But we'll see what happens. All right, thanks.
I'm not ready to go home. I don't want to go home. I'm really hoping that the people that are left to weigh in are going to be below me.
Cheryl, you lost 3 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 1.55%. Sherry, Cheryl, Daryl, you are still all in danger of falling below the yellow line. Daryl, you are still in danger of falling below the red line. Next, we're going to weigh in Miggy. You need to have lost more than 3 pounds to be above both lines and guarantee your safety here for one more week. Your current weight is
100. I don't know the last time I felt so happy with my weight.
Oh my God!
Congratulations, Maggie. Good job.
Yes. 199 is not my goal weight, but I am so motivated to keep bringing those numbers down. It's like I broke a barrier and I feel like I am out of control with working out.
Maggie, you lost 7 pounds this week for a total percentage of weight loss of 3.4%. Congratulations, Maggie. That's good enough for second place. You are definitely safe from elimination. You are here for one more week. We have 2 people left to weigh in. Daryl, I'm sorry to tell you that you are definitely below the yellow line and in danger of falling below the red line. Cheryl and Sherry, you are both still in danger of falling below the yellow line. Next, we're going to weigh in Lance.
Just getting back from the Olympic Training Center in Colorado, I have no clue what kind of numbers I'm gonna pull. I've got all these questions going through my mind. Did I eat the right things? Because at the Olympic Training Center, they had a lot more things with more fat than we're used to eating here at the ranch.
Lance, your previous weight was 314 pounds. In order to guarantee your safety, be above both lines, you need to have lost more than 5 pounds. Your current weight is
305. I've lost 60 pounds total.
Thank you, Lance. Congratulations.
300 has been my killer weight for me. I'm wanting to break that 300 mark awful bad.
Lance, you lost 9 pounds for a total percentage of weight loss of 2.87%. Fourth place. You are definitely here for one more week. We have one person left to weigh in, which means, Cheryl, you are definitely below the yellow line tonight. Daryl, you are also below the yellow line tonight, in danger of falling below the red line.
There's only one more person to weigh in. My dad has officially fallen below the yellow line. I just pray to God he doesn't fall below the red line. That would just be devastating.
So, Melissa, either you or Daryl will fall below the red line tonight and be automatically eliminated from this campus. There will be no deliberation, no vote. You will have to leave the gym immediately. Melissa, you're up.
Going up to the scale, of course I'm nervous. I can't figure out my body because I go from losing 19 to gaining a pound, to losing only 1 pound, to 11 pounds. I don't trust my body. I can do what I'm supposed to do, and sometimes the numbers are there and sometimes they're not.
All right, Melissa. Last week you weighed in at 198 pounds. In order to make sure you are above that red line, you need to have lost more than 3 pounds. Your current weight is 100. All right, Melissa, it's either you or Daryl who will fall below that red line, which means you'll be automatically eliminated from the competition. In order to make sure you are above that red line, you need to have lost more than 3 pounds. Your current weight is
1 pound. I gain a pound. What's wrong? What is the problem? I don't get it. I'm not doing any less than anyone else. I'm eating what I'm supposed to be eating. Why am I gaining a pound?
At least I get to see my kids. I don't want to leave this house because I love it and I love the people here. But if anyone has to go home today, I think it should be me, because everyone else out there has serious medical issues that they have to deal with. And my distance to my goal weight is way less than anyone else's. And I will get there. And when you see me at the finale, I will be at my goal weight. Y'all have to keep Lance here. And you have to keep him motivated. He can't come home before 250. He cannot come home before 250.
Lance's weight is a huge, huge issue in our house. And he has to be here.
Do what you know you have to do. I'll be at home. I'll be with the kids. Everything's gonna be fine. You're here to focus on you, to lose the weight.
I am leaving Lance in other people's hands, and I'm not going to be here to encourage him or to motivate him or to inspire him, but he's got Bob, and Bob is going to do great things for Lance.
I'm going home. Don't follow me.
Yes, ma'am.
Melissa, I'm sorry to tell you that with that 1 pound weight gain, you have fallen below the red line, and you are automatically eliminated. You are not the biggest loser. You are still in it for the at-home prize of $100,000. And we look forward to seeing you at the finale.
Thank you.
Thank you.
love you too. Do not give up, dear.
Melissa, it is time for you to go.
Bye, Melissa. Take care.
The reality is I've known all along I would go home at some point. I'm not big enough to be here for the long haul. And so it's way earlier than I wanted it to be. It's way earlier than I wanted it to be.
Bob, Jillian, it's time to say goodnight.
Thanks for everything you've done.
Cheryl, Daryl, I'm sorry to tell you both that you have fallen below the yellow line, and unfortunately one of you will be eliminated tonight. This is Olympics week, and at the Olympics, they don't vote to see who wins. So tonight, we're not going to have a vote either. Tonight, Cheryl and Daryl are going to go head-to-head in an elimination challenge. Whoever wins stays here for one more week. The loser is eliminated, and we'll be going home tonight.
What?
Cheryl, Daryl, come with me. Follow me.
Coming up, the Biggest Loser transformation moment. See how the eliminated player looks today. The Biggest Loser Club is changing lives.
Cheryl, Daryl, take a spot.
Mom and Daryl get a chance to fight for themselves, and a challenge is what's gonna keep them here, not a vote.
Daris, next to me.
The one thing I do like about the elimination challenge is that it takes me out of having to vote to send either one of them home. I did not want to have to vote for either Cheryl or Daryl.
All right, this is your elimination challenge. Each of you has a torch. Your job is to keep your flame lit. You will each balance a torch stem on your head. When it falls away, your flame will go out and you will be eliminated. Take your torch stems and find your balance.
I'm gonna give this everything I got. I'm not ready to go home. I couldn't even imagine not being here with Andrea.
I was gonna do anything in my power to stay here. I do not wanna go home. I wanna be here as long as I can with Daris and for Daris.
Take your hands away in 3, 2, 1. Cheryl, Daryl have both found their focus, both remaining completely still.
Move your feet around, Dad, if you have to. Stay focused.
You have been at this for 1 minute.
Just keep breathing, Dad.
I was trying to focus. My knees started just burning. I had to get that out of my mind and focus, and I was trying to get time to pass without feeling the pain.
Doing good, Mom.
That's 3 minutes. Four minutes, guys. That's 5 minutes. Daryl, Cheryl, you've been doing this for 6 minutes.
My dad is definitely uncomfortable. You can tell that he's on the verge of crying. He's in so much pain. Literally, my heart was breaking.
Cheryl making her first adjustment.
Her torch was kind of crooked. It definitely looks like her torch could fall off. One little mistake, she's going home.
I'm not ready to go home. I'm gonna give this everything I got. My quads were just ripping. It was the most excruciating pain that I've ever been in.
The challenge is mine.
This experience on The Biggest Loser was remarkable, and I have zero regrets.
Would I have you doing anything that you can't do?
I am most proud of the workout that I had with Bob.
This
it's what's gonna get you to change. This, it's what's gonna make you stronger. Pushing outside of your comfort zone. Finding all new limits.
He killed me in that gym. And I did everything he asked me to do.
These are perfect. Two more.
He is so inspiring. When you're in the gym and you just want to give up and you don't believe that you can go anymore, he will not let you believe that you'll fail.
Last one. Everything you got. That's it.
I truly don't believe that I would have come as far as I've come if I didn't have Bob Harper. The Melissa that came to the ranch 6 weeks ago didn't believe in herself. But the Melissa that's leaving the ranch today knows that there's nothing she can't do. America, next time you see me, I will be the Melissa Morgan that I'm supposed to be.
When I started on The Biggest Loser, I weighed 233 pounds. Today I weigh 175 pounds. I've lost a total of 58 pounds. When I came home from campus, it was me. And, you know, I essentially am living as a single mom. You know, Lance is still out there and I'm having to raise the kids. I'm having to deal with some work issues now and I'm trying to implement this new lifestyle that I fully intend to embrace the rest of my life. And let's not pretend, it's a struggle.
A six.
I always thought, how cool would it be to box? And so when I did it on campus, I thought, I could like this.
Three, four, five.
It's been easier to sit back and say, you know, it'd be really great to box. Wouldn't that be great? But all I did was talk about it. I'm not talking about it anymore. Now I'm doing it.
Very good.
Today, I am truly addicted.
I'm addicted. I love it.
Two, there you go. Look at the bag.
My hope for the future is to encourage my children to live a healthy life and to pay it forward.
Job.
People were asking me, how do you think your mom looks like? And I'm like, she looks hot.
I think that there are a lot of things about my story that I hope will resonate with America. You know, the fact that I struggled with my weight on the scale as much as I did, that was real. Every bit of that was real. And what I want people to realize is, give it time. By the end of the day, I feel dang good about Melissa Morgan.